What is up, everybody? Welcome to the second video of Saturday. You're probably noticing I'm wearing the same thing that I did on Friday. Well, this video took a little bit longer to make because I had to create a spreadsheet, link of which is in the description down below, and a lot needed to go into it. So basically what this video is, it is three parts to it, but the main first part is we go over the total amount of rewards you can pick up that is guaranteed in this, or guaranteed at the point of recording this video, that we know. So what you can get from objectives and other things as well. And then what we're going to do, the second part to it, is look at your strategy for rifts and also a spreadsheet that's really going to help you out, and how it works from the point of balancing your take home from the rifts event. I have to make that very clear. That's what this video will indeed look on. So facts of what we know is that there's going to be, each quest has four difficulties, each of which you can do 28 times. So it's like saying 28 plus 28 plus 28 plus 28 for week one. The same thing for week two, week three, week four. You can go on what seems to be all the difficulties, which is really good and can be very, very helpful. And that is going to be fantastic. There's also going to be something called a temporal lockpick, which allows you to guarantee what you're going to be able to pick up. Now, I will be doing a full video on this next week when the content drops, but I want to be very clear about the process and also balancing certain things that you can get. And look, like, there's guaranteed things, guaranteed rewards you can pick up from the various different things on screen right now, and you can go and check it out in the link in the description. This is from the forum thread on the matter. So spreadsheet, let's kick things off now with this that's on screen right now, and that's the grand totals. I've only concentrated on the main ones, the ones that kind of have the more spicier things, more tailored for those are uncollected, Cavalier and Thronebreaker. Sorry to anyone lower than that, I just kind of feel like that's better to focus on those things, especially for this. So you get like a whole load of rewards. How does this all kind of like balance into part one? And as I said, part one is focusing on the guaranteed stuff. So you are guaranteed to get this if you do up to, if you do all of these objectives. I don't know, I would say from a Cavalier perspective, you're unable to, anyone lower than Cavalier, you're unable to get tier 3 alpha, which is an amazing thing. But you're looking at a take home of 1,006 star shards guaranteed, 10 5-star signature stones guaranteed, 27,000 catalyst fragments, 10% of a tier 5 class catalyst through 5 crystals at 2% each, of course, 9,000 tier 2 alpha fragments, 100,000 gold, 1 5-star awakening gem, and 5,000 5-star shards. All of those things are guaranteed, but also we don't know if we're getting a calendar, and also we don't know if we are getting more opportunities for catalysts and whatever more is from the solo event called the Cat's Meow, which, you know, is announced, but we just don't know what's in it. As Kabam say, game master rewards such as claws for alarm crystal shards, catalysts and more. So we just don't know what's in there. Kabam haven't kind of given any indication of what's within it, so it could mean that the rewards are kind of like added more to the totals. And that's very, very important, because this goes on to part two of the video. And the rifts and how to strategize your rifts grind, and understanding your totals up to, say, week three as to where you're going and how much you're picking up for the month. This goes into part two of the video, and part two focuses on the rift grind. Now, what I've done is I've created a spreadsheet. Now, it's up to you whether or not you want to go and check it out. Link in the description in any case. And I've done it to a way that I personally feel I can work it, and how I'm going to be creating kind of like stuff in the future, like doing, okay, after week two, which I'll do after 2 weeks, what have I got? Where am I planning to strategize my kind of take home? Because as I said, just to reiterate, you'll go through this and at the end of it, you may feel disappointed with your take home of rewards. This is why the lockpick is going to be considerably important in your final week. So here's a spreadsheet. It's blank spreadsheet, which is in the bottom tab of this. So you can see like there, the bottom tabs, which has got objectives take home, rift spreadsheet blank, rifts grind scenario, and how the side quest works, which I haven't finished yet. And I have to wait until it releases next week to kind of like finish it off. But in any case, the point remains here. I've done this in a certain way where I can track each of my runs. and what I pick up from my runs, I have a total there, and then I'll add it all together at the end of it. So I've got all the weeks there, and also all the correct, this is all correct against the forum thread post, which has all the different types of rewards in the various weeks, because they're not all the same each week. They do differ. I've also done a epic one, because as I said, this is going to be important for the strategy and going forward, which is, you know, looks like that. And that's exactly the same rewards that you would get. And as I said, this is very important because it allows you to change what your grinding rewards rise, and also deal with the problems that come with an RNG-based event. That's kind of like, you know, why I've done this. So that's the part two done, to kind of explain that. Part three is putting that into place and looking at strategy, okay? Let's talk about strategy now. Part number three is indeed the scenario and how we kind of look to then strategize. This is focused on legendary and epic, basically because I feel that the rewards are kind of better to look at, and especially because players want to know what they're getting, the better, spicier take-homes. And also that's important because if you're able to do epic and legendary, you need to strategize where you're going. And also if you're in a position of only being able to do epic, then you need to be able to understand where and what you should do for the foreseeable month, especially depending on targeting certain types of resources. But look, starting off with this and kind of explaining it, and it's up to you whether or not you want to use a spreadsheet, completely up to you. Tier 5 basic, say you only pick up 15,000 in run 1, run 2 of week 1 of legendary, you pick up tier 2 alpha 22,000. You pick up between 3 and 4 run 2 tier 4 class catalysts, 6 star shards 1,350, and 5 star shards 3,500 in run 6, 7 in run 7, 5,000 shards, okay? So that all adds up. The same thing if you go through week 2, week 3, and week 4 of that. The same thing, again, over the other side when it comes to epic. You keep that log of information. You get the information that you grab. Okay, well, the first week has been great with tier 1 alpha, but I don't need tier 1 alpha. I picked up a little bit of 6-star shards. Okay, right, we're rocking and rolling. Up to week 4, you've done all these things. I'm not going to break down each and every week, but essentially you want to get to a total. And once you've got to, say, week 3, that's probably going to be the more important. Please ignore the fact of, like, you know, week 4s of these, because as soon as you reach week 3, you've got to make some key decisions about what you do, and then you make changes. So you could be, and here's an example right here, it all kind of like totals up, as I said. By week 3, you could have something like this. So the color schemes here is like, Cavalier players and upwards, oh, I have got 75,000 shards, 75,000 tier 5 basic fragments, great. I've got 44,000 tier 2 alpha fragments, great. I've got low 6-star shard take home in there. I've got a good amount of 5-star shards. And you're ultimately looking at this here and these numbers and going, do you know what? Rifts weren't that good to me. What the heck do I do? Well, this is when you change your perspective, you flip it, and you go, okay, my epic added to that isn't too good. Again, what do? Lockpicks. Use those lockpicks. Those lockpicks will be the things that will allow you to top up your rewards. And again, as I said, we'll be going over this next week. But in a nutshell, this is when you change what you're going to do. So you could say, right, well, for whatever reason, I get 4,950 six-star shards from the 4 weeks or 3 weeks that I've run this particular like legendary. And going, okay, right, well, that's that there. And also from the epic, I've picked up that adds into the total. So overall, 4,900 six-star shards. So that's a lot less than I would like. What do? Use 4 lockpicks on week 4 to get the additional 6-star shards. You could then pick up an additional 1,300 6-star shards from the final week. That then changes your total to 10,350 6-star shards from what would be a very kind of like annoying 4,950, a very disappointing, and then kind of topping up to 10,350, plus an extra 1,000 6-star shards from the objectives take home. So you could look to 11,350 6-star shards take home if you are interested in that. The only, like, the other scenario would be looking at, okay, well, tier 5 class tier 5 basic fragments, so you only get 75,000 total, plus your ones from Epic, it means that you could see 77,000 tier 5 basic fragments overall by the week 4 of all the runs. But you could also make that decision of changing that. It doesn't have to be that. You could use your 4 lockpicks to grab yourself some more tier 5B, which could see you up to 137,000 fragments overall. And that's 3 total basics. You add the extra 27,000 you get from the objectives and you're looking at nearly 4. So that's something to bear in mind. That week 3 and creating those totals and having something like a spreadsheet similar to this on screen right now could help you really pinpoint what you are looking to achieve from the month. It may not be all doom and gloom. Yes, it is an RNG-based event, but it doesn't mean to say like it's going to be ridiculously bad. This is a cool way to kind of like strategize your grind. This is a good way to strategize your rewards, disappointment versus RNG and success. So you kind of go like, okay, well, I make that decision. But how this really works is you don't have to grind all on as soon as you go in on week 4. You can like you don't have to grind right then and there. You can save all your grind until week 4 and make that decision, okay, well, I'm now going to go into the first 3, see what I get, and then kind of look at your totals and then go into week 4 at the end of it and go, right, well, I'll use my lockpick on week 4 to really kind of like pinpoint what you want to see out of the month. I'll be doing a full video on this. I just wanted to make a quick video to kind of like just go over the process. Just introduce the spreadsheet for those that are interested. If you're interested, as I said, link in the description down below. I'm personally looking forward to this. I don't know why. I'm really looking forward to it. But that's only because like I know what I get from Rifts. I know the RNG factor to it. And I will be doing fortnightly, every 2 weeks, videos about like how the process is going for me, top tips. But also I'll be doing a tips video for this next week when the event goes live. But that's been the video. Hope you enjoyed it. I don't know what I'll be doing now, maybe some other content and that, but yeah, check out some other things that are on screen right now, and I'll get this video out at the second video of Saturday, once I've kind of like finished some stuff with a spreadsheet and uploaded it to Google Drive, which there should be a link. Cheers everybody, have a good weekend. Bye bye.